Good morning, children. So I welcome you again to your online English classes. In the last class, I had already completed the poem from your first flight book that named Amanda. And today let me commence the new lesson from the same book, that is the 100 Dresses Part 1. And the writer is L. Bazar Esther. So we came to know that this lesson is divided in two parts. Okay, so let's commence with the first part, that is the 100 Dresses Part 1. Okay, so before you read, coming to the book, as you know well, I will be dealing the chapter paragraph wise, and I will deal all the difficult words in between. So be with me and try to understand the lesson thoroughly. So let me start now. Look in your book here. Before you read, how do we judge the people around us? By their money, wealth, and possessions. Or is there something of more enduring value to look for in a person? So hope so this question is for you, and you all are quite mature to answer this question, children. How do you judge the people? First you think over it, okay, whether on the basis of the wealth, money, or the things they possess, or something else. Something else I mean to say, the moral values. Enduring means the long lasting, that longs last. Okay, so what you will look for in a person? All the materialistic things, or the inner wealth and the inner beauty of a person? So this story is a sensitive account of how a poor young girl is judged by her classmates. Vanda Petronsky is a young Polish girl who goes to school with other American children in an American town. These other children see Vanda as different in many ways. Can you guess how they treat her? So here again, it's a question asked to you. So this story is of a sensitive, poor young girl, okay, who was judged by her classmates. In your classroom also, children, sometimes the situation occurs, okay, and you also might have gone through this type of situations, maybe or may not be, but we will see how Vanda Petronsky, who was a Polish girl means who belonged to Poland, she was from Poland, but she was studying here with American children. It means though she was Polish, but now she was staying in America. So how all the other children treated her differently, that we will come to know here in this chapter. Read the information in the box below. Find out more about this community, okay, from an encyclopedia or the internet. Encyclopedia, you all know very well, the book which gives knowledge of all the branches. So let's know about this community, the Polish American community in the United States. The first Polish immigrants arrived in America in 1608, but the largest wave of Polish immigration occurred in the early 20th century when more than 1 million Poles migrated to the United States. The Polish state did not exist at that time, and the immigrants were identified according to their country of origin rather than to ethnicity. They were identified as Russian Poles, German Poles, and Austrian Poles. Okay, so what here is mentioned over here, the first Polish immigrants, you know well, those who go to settle in the foreign countries. Okay, they leave their country and go to some other country to settle there permanently. So the first Polish immigrants who left their place, and they, where they arrived, they came to America in 1608. Okay, but most of the people the whole lot of Polish immigration. It occurred in which century? 20th century, when more than 1 million Poles means the Polish people only, they migrated to United States. They all left their place and they came to settle in America. Okay, but that time the Poland was not a state. It didn't exist till that time, and that's why these immigrants, they were identified. Okay, they were known on basis of what? On the basis of their country of origin, rather than ethnicity, means here relating to their human race, not according to that, but they were identified, they were known according to their country of origin, from where they originated, as Russian Poles, those who came from Russia, those Polish people were known as Russian Poles. Those Polish people who came from German, they were known as German Poles, and who came from Austria, they were known as Austrian Poles. So one of the most notable Polish American communities is in Chicago and its suburbs. So Chicago is sometimes called the second largest Polish city in the world, next only to Warsaw, the capital of Poland. Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated against in the United States, as were the Irish, Italians and Jews. So what is here to know? One of the most notable means famous, which is the most famous Polish American communities? It is in Chicago and its suburbs. Suburbs means the areas which are outside a city, or also we can say outskirts, okay, which the areas which are outside any city. So the one of the known Polish American communities, it stays in Chicago and most of its suburbs, outskirts, okay. And that's why Chicago is also called as the second largest Polish city in the world. So maximum of the Polish people who belong to Poland, they just stayed there, next only to Warsaw. What is this place, Warsaw? It is the capital of Poland. And these Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated, okay, they were differentiated when they were in United States of America, like the Irish people, Italians and Jews. According to the United States 2000 census, 667,414 Americans of age 5 years and older reported Polish as the language spoken at home, which is about 1.4% of the people who speak languages other than English, 0.25% of the US population. So just maximum of the Polish people, they emigrated to America, okay, which is about 1.4% of the people, okay, who speaks, means that many people were there who were speaking other language than English there. So this was the just a basic introduction about that community, okay. Now coming to the main chapter, so now listen here very carefully. Today, Monday, Wanda Petronsky was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. Usually, Wanda sat in the seat next to the last seat in the last row in room 13. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat. The corner of the room where there was most scuffling of feet, most roars of laughter when anything funny was said, and most mud and dirt on the floor. So what is said over here? It was the day, that day was Monday, okay, when Wanda Petronsky, she was not in her seat, she was not found sitting in her seat, but still nobody, not even these two girls, okay, namely Peggy and Madeline, who always used to make fun of that girl Wanda, okay? They never noticed her absence. These two girls who used to make fun of Wanda every now and then, they even didn't notice that today Wanda was absent in the class. Okay, so where Wanda used to sit in the classroom, she used to sit next to the last seat in the last row. The classroom was allotted room number 13 and she occupied the last seat in the last row in that room. And that was in the corner of that room where the rough boys mostly used to sit. Okay, rough means here we can say very indisciplined boys who never want to attend the classes and disturb the classes. Okay, yes children, you may just create a scene of your own classroom. Sometimes it happens in your class too, isn't it? So that too happened over here, that the girl Wanda used to sit there in the last row where the indisciplined boys used to sit in the corner of the room where there was more scuffling. Scuffling, you understand, that is the rubbing of the shoes on the ground to create that noise, irritating noise, okay, to rub the shoes. So those boys, indisciplined they were, means they were just creating the noise by rubbing their shoes, and they used to just laugh louder when anything funny was said in the class. And there only in that seat, most mud and dirt on the floor could be seen. Okay, these boys mostly they go out, then they again come in and they bring a lot of mud in their shoes and just scuffle the shoes to make the noise. Okay, next para. Wanda did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. On the contrary, she was very quiet and rarely said anything at all. And nobody had ever heard her laugh out loud. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crooked sort of smile, but that was all. So, whether we can say that Wanda was also such sort of girl, that rough girl? No, she wasn't indisciplined, she wasn't noisy. On the contrary means, on the other hand, against that, she was very calm and quiet girl and rarely she used to open her mouth. Okay, still, she used to sit in that place where there was a lot of mischievousness done by other children. And even nobody had even heard her laugh loud. She never laughed in the class louder, in loud voice. Okay. And sometimes, if she wants to just give a smile, she used to just crooked means very awkward type of smile she used to give. That's all. Nothing more for that girl to do in the classroom. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in that seat, unless it was because she came all the way from Boggins Heights and her feet were usually caked with dry mud. But no one really thought much about Wanda Petronsky once she sat in the corner of the room. So, and nobody exactly can say that why Wanda used to sit in that last corner of the classroom, okay. But we can say that it was, the reason maybe because she came from Boggins Heights. Boggins Heights is a place mentioned over there. Okay, and her feet were usually caked with dry mud. Caked with dry mud means the feet were fully covered. There was a layer of mud in her shoes can be seen. So, from this situation, we can say that, we can just guess that the place from where she used to come was not so developed place. It was somewhere she used to go through the mud and all. That's why her shoes were always covered with dry mud. Okay. But no one really thought much about Wanda. But no one took care of that. Okay. About that Wanda Petronsky. Once she used to take her seat, then no one else had to bother about her. The time when they thought about Wanda was outside of school hours, at noon time when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before school began. when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard. Means what happens now? Means when Vanda Petransky was inside the classroom, no one used to see her or to bother about her. Okay. But when they leave the class outside, they came out of classroom. Okay. And when the school hours gets completed, either at the noon time, means when they come to school or while going back from school, okay, that time only all these children of her class, they used to think about her. They may be in the groups of two or three or even sometimes more children, and they used to make a group and talk, seeing Vanda and laugh on her. Okay, means they used to make fun of Vanda Petransky, seeing her appearance and seeing the way she comes to school. Then sometimes they waited for Vanda to have fun with her. So in the classroom they never noticed Vanda, but when these children, either in the morning whether they are in the group during the before the class starts or when the class hours ends, that time they used to form a group and they just wait for Vanda to make fun of her. The next day, Tuesday, Vanda was not in school either and nobody noticed her absence again. Now first day Monday, she was absent in school. Again the next day Tuesday, Vanda again was absent in the school, but still nobody noticed her absence in the classroom. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children who got good marks and who didn't track in a whole lot of mud, did notice that Vanda wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in school. She was pretty, she had many pretty clothes, and her hair was curly. Maddie was her closest friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Vanda's absence was because Vanda had made them late to school. Okay, so what happens? Monday and Tuesday, on both these days, Vanda was not at all noticed by anyone in the classroom. But on the third day, Wednesday, both these girls, Peggy and Maddie, who used to sit always in the front bench, okay, with all the other children, means the good children who used to concentrate in the class, who were good in studies and who used to score good marks, okay. So, they never track in a whole lot of track here means they never came with that, walked with that muddy legs. Okay, they did notice, they noticed that day that Vanda was absent in the classroom. Means both these girls who were good in studies, who were sitting in the front bench with all the good children who used to score good marks and who never had their shoes muddy, they noticed that Vanda was not present in the class that day. This Peggy, she was the most popular girl in the school, okay. She was very famous girl, she was very pretty also, and she had very pretty clothes and her hair was also curly, okay. And Maddie, she was her closest friend, very closest friend of Peggy, and they both noticed Vanda's absence. Why? What was the reason? Because Vanda had made them late to school, because they were waiting to see Vanda, and just for what purpose? They wanted to make fun of Vanda, but she was absent, and due to that both of these girls, they got little bit late to school. They had waited and waited for Vanda to have some fun with her and she just hadn't come. So this is the reason I told you why they got late to school. They were just waiting for Vanda, that when, as soon as she will come, they will just pass some comments or they will make fun of her. But it didn't happen. Vanda didn't come to school that day, and both of these girls, Peggy and Mary, got late to school. They often waited for Wanda Petransky to have fun with her. Often they used to do this, very often, okay, very commonly. Every time they used to wait for Wanda to make fun of her. Next para, Wanda Petransky. Most of the children in room 13 didn't have names like that. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Smith or Alan. There was one boy named Bounce, Wally Bounce, and people thought that was funny. But not funny in the same way that Petransky was. So now, what happens here? Wanda Petransky. Okay, many children were there in room number 13 studying together in the classroom. So many of them, means most of the children, their names were easy to speak. Okay, like Thomas, Smith, Alan and likewise. Only there was one boy named Willie Bounce, and people used to think that it was also a little bit funny name, but not as funny as Wanda Petransky. Means they found Wanda Petransky quite strange, uncommon name in the group in the classroom. Okay, so that was also one of the reason why they used to make fun of Wanda. Wanda didn't have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She didn't have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. So now what we came to know next about Wanda, she didn't have any friends in that classroom. Okay, she used to come alone to the school and she used to go back home alone. And she always used to wear a faded blue dress. Okay, so always she used to wear, fade means dim color. The color of that dress got so dim, it got faded. And it didn't hang right, means it was not properly, means it didn't fit her properly also, that dress. It was quite loose and it just hang over her body. Though it was very clean, she used to wear neat and clean, but it was never ironed. Okay, and she didn't have any friends. But when the school gets over, lot of girls used to just go around her and talk to her. And sometimes what happens, the girls surrounded her in the schoolyard itself. Okay, and as she stood watching the girl, little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. Okay, so when Wanda, when she stops there, she stands watching the other girls, little girls who used to play hopscotch, a very common game. Children, you also, all the girls might be knowing, in which the children hop into and over the squares marked on the ground. Okay, interesting games. So when other girls used to play that game on that hard ground, then Wanda used to stand there and watch, and that time other girls surround her and used to talk to her, though they were not friends. Wanda, Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Wanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge, tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? Now see what happens. When Wanda used to stand alone without any friends, then Peggy would say in most courteous. Courteous means in a most civil way. Okay, very politely, in a polite manner. Okay, and that time, though she were talking to Miss Mason, was the class teacher. Okay, their class teacher. And when the time when they all were talking to their class teacher, that time Peggy would ask Wanda, what, giving one of her friends a nudge. Nudge means a gentle push, means she would just push a little bit her friend, and that time she would question Vanda about what? That how many dresses she had in her closet. Closet means almirah. So I hope you understood, children. To give a nudge means when something again you want to pull the leg of anyone, leg pulling was being done by here of Vanda by Peggy. That time to make it clear to all her friends standing there. So she wanted to ask Vanda that how many dresses she had. See, they were noticing that Vanda was every day wearing a very fade blue colored dress. Okay, that was also not ironed. So just again to make fun of her, Peggy raised a question. Next, 100, Vanda would say. 100, exclaimed all the little girls incredulously, and the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. So when Peggy raised this question, so Vanda replied, I have 100 dresses. So listening this, all the girls who used to play incredulously means showing the disbelief, means they never wanted to believe that. They were shocked listening this, that she may have 100 dresses with her to wear. Okay, so listening this, the little girls who used to hop and play that game, they may stop playing and they wanted to listen to her, that what she's saying. How strange it is that she has 100 dresses. Yeah, 100 all lined up, said Vanda. See how confidently Vanda was here, that yeah, I'm sure that I have 100 dresses, and that also lined up means they all are hanging in a beautifully in my almirah in a line. Then her thin lips drew together in silence, and then she would keep complete silence. She won't say or utter any further words. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. See the extreme of that mocking. So she was not satisfied listening only 100 dresses. So she was asking now that what are they like? Means what type of dresses you have? Whether all are silk dresses, I hope, I bet means all the dresses you might be having silk dresses, Peggy said. Okay. Yeah, all silk, all colors. So what was the reply of Vanda, you see, children? Yes, I have all the 100 dresses of silk material. Silk is the most beautiful and costlier also. So she agrees that I have all the colored dresses, and that also of silk material. And again Peggy was not just quitting there, she's asking velvet too. Velvet is again a soft cloth material, it is also the costlier one. She's asking, you might be having velvet dresses also? Yeah, velvet too, 100 dresses, Vanda would repeat stolidly, all lined up in my closet. So whatever she was being asked, she said very politely in a normal way, yeah, I have the velvet dresses, and in those 100 dresses. And stolidly means not showing any feeling. Okay, means without any feeling, just in a very normal way she was telling, yeah, all the dresses are lined up in my almirah, all the 100 dresses of all the colors. Then they would let her go, and then before she would gone very far, they couldn't help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. Okay, after asking all these questions to her, then they allows her, who? Peggy and Maddie and all the other girls who used to surround her and ask her the questions. So they would allow her to go now. And before she would gone very far, means when she was near to them only, okay, what they used to do, they just couldn't help start shriek, means you know, with the loud sound. Okay, so they start bursting out into loud laugh. Okay, and peals of laughter means great laughter only. For what purpose, you know? Just to make fun of Vanda, that see the girl who is always wearing only one dress, and how she is saying to us that she has hundreds of dresses of all colors. So this is just a mocking one which is being said here. 100 dresses, obviously the only dress Vanda had was the blue one she wore every day. So why did she say she had 100? What a story. Okay, so these girls, they couldn't digest that thing. Okay, so what again they wanted to know? The girl who only used to wear a single blue dress every day, so why she wants to say the lie that she has 100 dresses? What a story she's cooking up over here. Okay, so the next question they used to raise was, how many shoes did you say you had? Now the next time again, and all the girls, they started again teasing her, asking her that how many pairs of shoes she had. 60 pairs all lined up in my closet. Again Vanda very confidently she said, I have 60 pairs of shoes and all are kept in a proper way in my almira. Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. All alike. Okay, so exaggerated politeness means false politeness, means though they were asking politely to her, but in a false way, they didn't want to be polite. Okay, so what they asked in a just false polite way, all are alike. Oh no, every pair is different, all colors, all lined up. Whether all your 60 pairs of shoes are alike, of same type. Okay, so what she said, no, they all are different. I have 60 pairs of all different colors and all kept in a proper way in my almira. Oh no, every pair is different, all colors, all lined up. So the same thing again, they all were feeling so strange that why this girl wants to say lie again and again. Okay, but they couldn't understand this. Peggy, who had thought up this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the last to leave. Finally Vanda would move up the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had, finishing the walk to school alone. So now when these girls, they surround her and ask her different questions every day, so what happens now? Peggy, who was the mastermind of this game, okay, the game means who used to just want to mock Vanda, and Maddie, who was her inseparable, means who can't be separated, very fastest friend, okay, closest friend, they were always the last to leave the school. And after that, when Vanda used to move up the street, she used to move, but that time the girl's eyes were very dull, means she was really feeling very bad, with her mouth closed. She used to hitch means to just pull up the shoulder every now and then. It is just the way how she used to walk while going back home. Okay, the funny way she had, and after finishing the school, she used to go alone back to her home. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies, and she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. If anybody had said to her, don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Vanda, she would have been very surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that that was a lie. Why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person else. Why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. So see here now what happens. Peggy, who was doing such a lot of things, creating problems and teasing Vanda, but still she was not really cruel, she was not unkind, she was a very kind girl. Okay, with what is said here, why she was a kind girl? Because she always used to protect the small children from bullies. Bullies means what? those who frightens the weaker people with the power. Okay, you in your class also, children, you may notice sometimes there are few students who bullies others. Okay, means they want to show their strength, those who are little bit weaker or calm, so they want to show that how powerful we are, so they bully others. Okay, so here also, when the small children were bullied by someone, she used to protect the small children. Who? Peggy. And sometimes when she used to see the animals mistreated, okay, if someone treats badly the animal, she even used to cry for them. Okay, and that much soft heart she had. And if anybody, means anyone, asked her that she never thinks that she's getting cruel to treat Vanda, means if she had such a good heart, then why she's behaving in such a odd way with Vanda? So she would surprise at that question, that you want to say me cruel. Okay, Peggy used to say, I am not at all cruel. The problem is that why that girl is always telling lie. That was the problem. That's why she wanted to get the actual answer from Vanda's mouth. Okay, but the way she just had used, okay, it was wrong. But the thing was that she says, if she don't have 100 dresses, why that girl wants to say the lie that she has 100 dresses? Okay, and though she was not an ordinary person according to Peggy, because she had such a strange name, Vanda Petronsky, so she wanted to know the reality about that girl, so she used to poke her every time. Okay, and anyway, they never made her cry. But the reason, at last the thing was that Peggy and Maddie, they never made Vanda cry. Okay, as for Maddie, this business of asking Vanda every day how many dresses and how many hats, so according to Maddie, when this Peggy, she every day, when she used to ask Vanda that how many dresses she has and how many hats and all she has, she never liked that. Okay, and how many this and that she had was bothering her. Maddie was poor herself. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Thank goodness she didn't live up on Boggins Heights or have a funny name. So here what it is said, that though Mary was the closest friend of Peggy, but she never liked that Peggy used to ask Vanda again and again about her dresses and all her hats and shoes and everything many times. Okay, and she had was means here that it was really bothering her. She was not feeling well of that. Maddie, the reason was that Maddie herself was from poor family. Okay, she was also from poor family, and she also used to wear somebody's given clothes. Hand-me-down means here the old clothes handed down by someone, maybe the relatives or friends, who used to give their old clothes. Okay, so she also used to wear those types of clothes only, the hand-me-down clothes. But the only difference was that she didn't live in Boggins Heights, or she didn't have any funny name like Vanda Petronsky. Okay, so children, let me stop here today, and I will continue this lesson tomorrow again. So till here, try to get it again and read it thoroughly and understand it according to your intelligence. Okay, so till next class, goodbye. And